Are you aware that your laptop knows more about you than you may even think of? And when you go online, all your sensitive information is broadcast throughout the entire world. For example, you must have noticed lot of times whatever we think in our mind only, do not talk to anyone about them or do not search on the internet, it's only in our mind. Yet we start seeing ads related to them on our laptop and mobile phones. Laptop is aware of every aspect of your personality, routine, and behavior. Clearly, we live in an era of artificial intelligence. Who you are, where you are, pictures of your family, friends, and favorite places you have traveled, your likes and dislikes, favorite foods, internet searches, favorite websites, how much time you spend on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, or YouTube, all of your contact information, email IDs and passwords, your shopping list, purchases, trips, flights, and upcoming bills, what's on your to-do list and what you are talking about, all are included. It's frightening to think that so much of your life has been recorded and catalogued. The Windows operating system is known for gathering data and providing it to its Microsoft headquarters, especially following the launch of Windows 10. In fact, a high-level summary of the data that is collected, such as location, diagnostics, relevant AdWords, and speech recognition, is now shown to you during the first setup of Windows 10 and 11. It's important to keep your data private in this new digital age, but it's hard to do so when even our operating systems beaming information back home. Although Microsoft collects these data for diagnostics and to personalize your Windows experience, some of its application tracks your keystrokes, browsing history, search queries, and often sell this data to the third party that you may never even heard of. These companies or apps collect and store the sensitive information of millions of individuals and utilize this data for targeted ad campaigns, market research, and much more. Let's now find out some of the simplest and straightforward ways to manage and protect your privacy in Windows without affecting system speed and upcoming upgrades. It will also boost your system performance. Although I am using Windows 11 for this example, the procedure is the same on Windows 10. So let's crack the Windows. Without wasting any more time, let's go back to our laptop screen. Click on search and type settings. Click on apps. Then apps and features. Here, click on the first option. Choose where to get apps. Here, pre-selected is anywhere and it's highly unsafe. Click it and select the Microsoft Store only. Now, whenever we'll try to install any third-party app, Windows will give a safety warning and will connect to the Microsoft Store to download and install it from there. Now, go back or tap backspace key twice to go back and click on the system. Notifications. And scroll down at the end of the page. Just uncheck all these options. Through all these options, we are giving permission to Windows to track and collect my personal data like my search history, language, and a lot more, and show me relevant ads and suggested content. Again, go back and click on Privacy and Security. Here, we'll manage some of the Windows permissions. Click on General. And switch off all these options. We don't want to share advertising ID and language list to internet to get annoying ads. If you like this video, just don't forget to subscribe the channel and click on the bell icon to get the latest updates, tips and tricks on Windows platform. If you have any query or suggestion, please do comment below. Now click on speech. Just turn off this online speech recognition. There is no harm by turning this off and all your apps will work fine. Go back and click on Diagnostics and Feedback. Just turn off this Send Optional Diagnostic Data option. Your device will be equally secure and will operate normally. Click on this arrow in front of Improve Inking and Typing and turn this off. Same way, just click all these arrows and turn them off. Also clear all data that Microsoft has already stored on their servers. Again, go back and click on this activity history option. Need to uncheck this store my activity history option, as we don't want Windows to save information about websites I browse or how I am using apps and services. Go back and scroll a bit. Here we have a lot of apps that requires permissions of automatic access. We'll switch off some of these. Click on the location. Here we can disable Windows to determine your location. You can turn this off altogether or can do app by app. I'll prefer to turn off some of the apps to automatically determine my location, and will turn location on whenever required by any specific app. We still have some more options to turn off, but as I have told earlier, we don't want to degrade our machine's performance. Some Microsoft apps need permission to give us updates and smoothen our work experience. So that's enough. You are secured now. That's all for today's video. Meet you soon. Goodbye.